Guest, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Kanto?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes.
Guest, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Quill?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him.
Duly noted.
Me clothes was new and me money was too. In the morning with them she fled.
I've heard Louisbourg could be a linchpin in the war. If the Royal Navy can take that fort, it'll be clear sailing down the St. Lawrence.
Ready to fire, sir! They're coming up for a
We think we've been on top! Fire! Fire!
Awaiting orders!
Fire! Fire!
Put a shot through at
them! Loose all and trim sharp to the wind!
Montreal. Tide is turning.
General Wolfe will give that craven Montcalm a right thrashing.
I've been looking forward to that since Fort William Henry.
With If this bloody war over, we'll finally bring order to this damned continent.
Down! Catch some wind!
Not here would take more than that, friend.
Thank you.
We should reinforce the Morrigan with these supplies, Shay. As we were fishing off Haysborough Light,
there's a
Pulling and trolling all night in that windy old weather, stormy old weather. The goods. Let us check out the Morrigan and new finery.
Get me some speed!
I don't like that wind, sir!
Keep a weather eye open!
Dark skies! A
Ready to fire, Captain!
Ready to charge against them!
We must take care.
Fire! 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 F
me to the drink when you can!
Pull them in! With the wind!
Taken, we can improve the ship, Captain.
Twas a cold and dreary morning in December.
Squall, pick it up, Captain.
There's the Gallatin, boys. Of saves.
Fire! 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 F
Gist, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook?
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid of Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him.
Duly noted.
I've heard Louis. If the Royal Navy can take that hold, it'll be clear sailing down the St. Lawrence.
William Henry.
With this bloody war over, we'll finally bring order to this damn continent.
I fear we'll take more than that, friend.
It's off the wind!
Thank you.
Get the yards off the wind! Fire!
Thank you.
could reinforce the Morrigan with these supply ships.
Get the mainsail!
What we've taken, we can improve the ship, Captain. Away anchor!
Guest, do you know why the Grand Master is so interested? Captain Cook.
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And if I trust my favorite barmaid in Halifax, he also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering secret codes. A man with such a skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of strict honesty and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep his business secret, especially with his mathematical ignorance and clever and cracking tools. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him.
Lead out.
I've heard Louisbourg could be a linchpin in the war. If the Royal Navy can take that port, it'll be clear sailing down the St. Lawrence.
And on to Quebec and Montreal. The tide is turning.
General Wolfe will give that craven Montcalm a right thrashing.
I've been looking forward to that since Fort William Henry.
With this bloody war over, we'll finally bring order to this damned continent.
I fear it would take more than that, friend.
Let's go.
Loot down! Catch some wind! Loot!
There was a ship, she sailed to Spain. Oh, oh, roll and go! There was a ship, came home again. Bodies on the forecastle yard. And what do you think was in her hold? Oh, oh, roll and go! There was divers, there was
trap more. To fall!
Bodies on the forecastle yard. And what was in her lazarine? Oh, oh, roll and go! Good split peas and bad bulls.
The goods. Let us deck out the Morrigan in new finery.
Get too close, Bryce!
Sally Branches.
Mama, va rejoindre Tremblay. Réveille-le s'il dort.
Arrête de gueuler, Landry. C'est ta patrouille, on en reparlera demain. Lefebvre, Arsenal est en train de dégueuler sa vie. Je te colle sa patrouille.
De sa blessure.
Marcelin est en train de dégueuler sa vie.
Charles,
je colle sa patrouille.
En reste rien jusqu'à ce qu'il se remette de sa blessure.
Lefebvre, Marcelin est en train de dégueuler sa vie. Je colle sa patrouille.
Ça, au moins, je trouve ça réconfortant de voir les gens se soucier de leur habitat.
Arrête de gueuler. C'est ta patrouille, on en reparlera demain.
Je l'ai en joue. Je le vois, je peux tirer.
Lefebvre, Marcelin est en train de dégueuler sa vie. Je te colle sa patrouille.
Charles, je n'en rien jusqu'à ce qu'il se remette de sa blessure.
Ça marche. Va rejoindre Tremblay. Réveille-le s'il dort encore.
Charles, tu remplaces rien jusqu'à ce qu'il se remette de sa blessure.
Réveille-le s'il dort encore.
You have the key to my heart. Well, to the spoils here at the very least.
J'ai une mission spéciale pour vous. Suivez-moi. Comme une vache dans un couloir. Charles, remplace Terrien jusqu'à ce qu'il se remette de sa blessure. On double les patrouilles jusqu'à nouvel ordre. Je peux l'abattre d'ici. Félicien, j'ai une mission spéciale pour vous. Suivez-moi. Je peux l'abattre d'ici. Je l'ai en joue. Félicien, j'ai une mission spéciale pour vous. Suivez-moi. Charles, t'inspire rien juste... Ne bouge plus.
Thank you. Sir, don't hurt me. Let me live.
Attends-moi. Thank you.
The Grand Master is so interested in Captain Cook.
Well, sir, he's very intelligent and ambitious. His knowledge of seamanship is second to none. And the barmaid in Halifax. He also just became captain of his own man of war. He's also an expert at deciphering. A man with such skill is certainly an asset to our cause.
The kind of fellow we should welcome in the Order, then.
Well, he's a friend of mine, but the man has an annoying habit of... honesty, and a total lack of anything resembling guile. Makes it a little hard to keep secret business secret, especially when his mathematical brain is clever at cracking codes. Consider him an ally, but watch what you say around him. I've heard Louisbourg could be a linchpin in the war. If the Royal Navy can take that fort, it'll be clear sailing down the St. Lawrence.
Then on to Quebec and Montreal.
The tide is turned.
General Wolfe will give that craven Montcalm a right thrashing.
I've been looking forward to that since Fort William Henry.
With this bloody war over, we'll finally bring order to this damned continent.
Fire! Fire! Get out of range!
worthy.
Loose it, cut! He's off the way! Trevor's off the way!
We're tearing to splinters! Damage report!
Fire! Mate's out!
What we've t-
Mates out!
I dreamed a dream the other night. Lowlands! Lowlands away!
Briefing on top! Watch the wind!
Warship incoming, Captain! It's a brig! French ships!
They have help, Captain!
Get them aloft! Douse all sail!
Bring two warship boats!
Warship closing on us, sir! Brig, Captain! The flying French colors! They're not alone!
Watch your time, Captain!
We got a 15! Watch out, man!
Trip to
Dasteroid. We should reinforce the bargain with these supply ships.
Get me some.
We bear
all in the stunsail.
Thank you.
target sur la table.
Allez, ne vous laissez pas distancer.
Arrête-toi. Suis-moi.
Thank you.
Captain Cormac has the wheel!
Unfurl, mates! Let's move! On sail! She'll take it!
Loose capsule, scallops and royals!
HMS Pembroke, Captain James Cook's ship.
She's a beauty.
Man of war, fully armed. We should bring the Morrigan alongside. Master Kenway will surely be waiting.
Welcome aboard, gentlemen.
Good to see you again, Captain.
Captain Shay Cormac, Captain James Cook.
Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Pleasure's mine, sir.
Captain Cook uncovered a rather distressing stratagem, which I fear confirms our own intelligence.
Indeed. As we speak, our Royal Navy fleet is on its way to Louisbourg. However, the French have drawn up a preemptive strike against it. If they launch this attack...
Obviously, we cannot allow that to happen. Gentlemen, the Battle of Louisbourg could very well be the turning point which will finally bring this war to a close.
I don't know about you, but... I've had enough of war.
Then may I suggest you take the wheel, Captain Cormac? I think you might enjoy piloting a vessel with real, firepower.
I believe I shall, Captain.
Lawrence and Whitmore lead the three divisions of the Royal Navy.
Who's their commander?
Major General Amherst himself, back from Hanover.
You take an interest in the war, Shay?
Wouldn't want to disappoint you, sir.
Use of your own mortars, Shay. Crucial if we are to succeed.
Dear God, fire ships. Should they break through, they would devastate our fleet.
And we'd better not let that happen.
I recognize that vessel, sir! It's the Experto Prede!
Admiralty.
How fortunate he is that we have other priorities.
Agreed. We have to get rid of those fire ships.
We're right in their path! We have to sink that fire ship or get out of their way!
Creep the compasses and cannons!
Ease the main! Muzzle the cannons!
More fire ships!
Captain, look! Mortars!
Fire! Wisdom don't always mix, Captain. This isn't over yet, lads. Man the cannons! Douse the gallant Royal!
Take in that sheet!
There's the Royal Navy! We cleared the way just in time, Captain Cormac.
The tide of war is turning!
That was quite a crack, wasn't it?
It is too soon for celebrations. Adewale is still out there.
I'm sure we'll get another turn to dance with him, Master Kenway. Kenway seems determined to destroy Adewale.
Aren't you? He's a powerful man in his own right, and a symbol of hope for the assassins. Eliminating him would shake them to their core.
It would, I know. But it seems a shame. He's a good man, Guest.
So was the Elder Washington and Smith. I rather enjoyed drinking with him. Wardrop, too. Though the man could not hold his liquor. He and Weeks never got along, you know.
If you're trying to test my conscience, Guest, you've succeeded.
We live in a time of war, Shane, but it's always wartime for us. I sound like my uncle Jedediah. He was an old son.
Another time.
Nice.
Fire! Fire!
In order,
fire!
This is fire!
Fire!
Captain has the head.
Catch some wind! As much sail as you can!
Bearing dead straight to land!
Short sail! Get off the squall!
let him get away. I mean it.
That'll do. I'd have.
Stop!
Stop! You there!
What's your goal?
on a windy day, and we're waiting for the day, wait for the day, wait for the day that we get our pay. She was built in Roman times, held together with bits of toy, and we're waiting for the day, wait for the day, wait for the day that we get our pay. Nothing in a galley, nothing in a hole. Skipper's turned in with a bag of gold. If I wait for a day, we'll
tell the skipper! Haul in the
Dutchess! Captain's taking the waters!
Here's the lining up like France.
Captain, get the maids free!
Some cargo from a wreck over here, sir.
Captain, wait us.
The Lord a roving with you, fair maid. A roving, a roving, since roving has been my ruin. The Lord a roving with you, fair maid. I ask this maid to take a walk myself, but I do say, I ask this maid out for a walk, that we might have some
time for the wind.
A four, Captain!
Then a great big Dutchman rammed my bow, mark well what I do say. For a great big Dutchman rammed my bow and said, young man, this is mine vrouw! Oh, no, no, I'm roving with you, my a roving, a roving, since roving's been my true eye. I'll go no more a roving with you, fair maid. Then take fair warning, boys, from me, mark well what I do say. So take a warning, boys, from me, with other men's wives don't make too free. I'll go no more a roving with you, fair maid. A roving, a roving, since roving's been my rue eye. Go no more a roving with you, fair maid.
Have you checked the ship?
Keep your eyes out.
Sir, to
the
fore.
Some evening I will tell tales of.
Cannon ready.
Trip to fire!
Oh, Captain! On your mark, Captain!
Loose made sails!
The Isle of Fogo, Captain Cormac.
Yeah. Yeah.
Out! Let's go!
Loose topsails, gallants and rowers!
England, all Ireland. Ollie, Ollie, oh. Paddy McGinty, Paddy Jock and Jackie too. Paddy McGinty, Ollie, Ollie, oh. Shamrock and Rose boys, Shamrock and
Rose.
To the ding!
Short sail! Get off the world! Fire!
Stop it!
Hey! Run! How's the guy that survived? Let out some sail! Unfurl, maids!
Now we
Johnny Poker, do.
Oh, do me, Johnny Poker, the skip boat is a rover.
Do me, Johnny Poker, do.
Oh, do me, Johnny Poker, the meat is never sober.
Do me, Johnny Poker, do.
Oh, do me, Johnny Poker, the bosun is a tailor.
Do me, Johnny Poker, do.
Two to four.
Oh, do me, Johnny Poker, we'll always...
Fire!
We should reinforce the Morrigan with these supplies, Shay.
Man at sea!
Get them!
Loose topsails, gallants and royals!
Floating cargo for the taking, sir.
The way.
Let out some sail!
On your mark,
get the main screen!
Loose capsule, skeleton royals!
Floating cargo for the taking, sir!
Short sail! Get off the squad!
He's dead and gone! My dog, he's gray with a silver face.
Captain, this
reef the topsail and the gallant.
Don't lie about. Get to your sheets and haul.
Fire!
Meet the quarter.
Fire! They hit us, sir.
Give me some speed! All sail, she'll take it!
Full sails! Ready, boys?
Douse the
mate, clue up! Anywhere. Clue up! Take a swing at this bar! Oh no!
Tower. Give me some speed! Trip the yards off the wind!
Good shot.
Fisher!
Awaiting
Get a new finery.
Away, anchor!
Thank you.
Yo, my man is no object to me.
Bring the money down.
Oh, money down, eh, money down.
Bring the money down.
I went for a cruise around the town.
Bring the money down.
I there met a gal called Sally Brown.
Bring the money down.
Oh, I put my arm around her waist.
Bring the money down.
Says she, young man, you're in great haste.
Bring the money down.
Price for love is half a crown.
Bring the money down.
Turn to the
money
full.
Down, it's real money down.
Bring the money down.
Oh, the Yankee daughters of the back pay.
Bring the money down.
Will buy us rum for many a day.
Bring the money
down. Oh, if
I say that for it, Captain, a rather lively fishing hamlet. We are at the northern tip of the
That's booty.
We're ready and willing to do some good work, kind sir.
I see him!
I have a clear shot! In calling. Just keep pushing! Stop! Attack him!
I have got a good line on him! Ready to open fire! Lost sight of him! We have to find him again!
Thank you.
still be spread around here. No. Huh.